Stories help us understand our lives. They provide us with metaphors and archetypes to better comprehend our struggles and the larger world in which they take place. The characters within can become ciphers for our loved ones or reflections of our own strengths and weaknesses. But the truth is that life is far more complicated, painful, and beautiful than what can be defined by any single piece of fiction, no matter how honest it may be. Alison Bechdel's 2006 graphic memoir, Fun Home, is a recounting of her experience growing up in a family dominated both physically and mentally by her father, Bruce, who died, likely from committing suicide, when she was a young adult. As Alison discovers her own sexual identity as a lesbian, she soon comes to realize that her father was a closeted homosexual. The realization, both at the time it occurred and as an autobiographer reflecting on years gone by, causes Bechdel to reevaluate her family, her father, and herself. For Bechdel, who had been famous in the independent comic book scene for years before Fun Home was published in 2006, this graphic novel autobiography was a chance to face the past and her family in the only way that made sense for her, through fictional illusion. And while the vast majority of events told in Fun Home are firmly rooted in reality due to copious journaling done by Alison around the ages of 10 and 11, as well as in her late teens, the pain of the past must be incrementally dissected. When discussing the copious amounts of comparisons she forms between her parents and the stories they read during her youth, Bechdel divulges, "I employ these illusions not only as descriptive devices, but because my parents are most real to me in fictional terms, and perhaps my cool aesthetic distance itself does more to convey the Arctic climate of our family than any particular literary comparison." Throughout the course of Fun Home, Bechdel attempts to better understand her family and her father in particular through numerous literary allusions, comparing them to fictional characters in an effort to find a lens that finally makes sense of the chaos and pain. But what Bechdel quickly makes known through her ever-increasing amount of complex references is that no work of fiction is ever enough to truly encapsulate all the complicated relationships formed within a family. We see this effort to make sense of trauma and love through lenses take form in multiple ways, including depicting the stories that were read by her family during her youth, such as the plays they acted in or the films they watched. Bechdel's artistic stylings when detailing her past, which edge up to realism while still highlighting the fictionalization of the autobiographical approach, and her choice of literary allusions, which change with each of the six chapters. Together, these elements provide both author and reader with the ability to see intricate family dynamics from new angles. Often, Bechdel's choice to tell and retell the same events in light of new information provides a therapeutic method of understanding a painful childhood and its reverberations that are felt throughout life. Bechdel relives her early years in two specific eras. One, as a child around the ages of 10 and 11, growing up in her tumultuous family home during the course of several events she would only learn of years later. The other, as a college student discovering that she is a lesbian, and soon after coping with her father's death, likely by suicide. However, the author rejects linear storytelling in favor of jumping back and forth between these two periods, often retelling the same events in light of a new piece of information gathered from either era. In doing so, Bechdel highlights the impossibility of encapsulating her relationship with her father in a neat and tidy narrative. Even in the midst of transposing fictional allusions onto her family's story, the author proves that no single piece of fiction will ever be enough to understand her past. For Alison, her father Bruce, a part-time mortician and part-time English teacher with a passion for home remodeling, was the source of great pain for her, her mother, and her two brothers for many years. Coping with obsessive-compulsive disorder as a child and attempting to connect with her father through reading some of his favorite books while in college, Alison kept copious notes on her experiences in real life. It's these notes that helped Bechdel write Fun Home, and in the process, observe her own modern-day struggles while creating the book itself. The events of the past, which the author points out to be almost too coincidental to be true unless they were not proven by her journals as a child, see works of fiction that reflect her family intersect her life at key moments. Albert Camus' A Happy Death and The Myth of Sisyphus, highlighting opposing views on death, come into the lives of both Bruce and Alison at the time of the possible suicide. The works of F. Scott Fitzgerald posed an idealized life that young Bruce wanted for himself and his wife Helen, while their performance of The Taming of the Shrew more accurately reflects how beaten down Allison's mother became under the rage and scorn of her father. Works like The Wind in the Willows and The Addams Family gave young Allison the chance to see the world around her as a brighter and more lovely place, a respite from the tumultuous nature of home. Helen's participation in a performance of The Importance of Being Earnest allows her to express frustrations and artistry that had been stifled. And while a college course on James Joyce's Ulysses helps Allison find some connection with her father in his final year, it's Bruce's gift of earthly paradise to his daughter and Allison's gift of flying to her father, both autobiographies that deal openly with the topic of homosexuality that help them connect in a largely unspoken manner. These moments are brought to life by Bechdel's art, meticulous and layered with an extreme attention to detail. It walks a careful line between realism and caricature. As revealed by Bechdel, the artist took numerous photographs of herself posing as every character so as to provide a real-life basis for the family members she was depicting. When transposing one's own painful past into comic book form, it's clear that, for Bechdel, the more based in reality that the drawings can be, the more honest the story can be as well. However, Bechdel's characters still possess a somewhat heightened quality to their form, with clean line work and a slight exaggeration to facial features moving ever so slightly past reality. This becomes far more heightened when characters interact with photos in the narrative. These images contain a striking realism in their depiction, showcasing a closeness to Bechdel's personal history and emphasizing the author's efforts to dissect her family history through fiction, which cannot help but be continuously confronted by reality. These photorealistic moments invite the reader to pore over every detail within the photo, examining the truths that they reveal, as the characters do as well. Likewise, the character of Bechdel herself encounters some of her most striking revelations in the discovery of old photos. Whether that is in the comparison of her father as a young man to herself at the same age, or a photo taken of her father's lover, each of these discoveries show some form of truth that Allison had not yet discovered beforehand. Every page of Fun Home is drawn in black and white, with a grayish-blue ink wash providing the only colors seen. The choice literally covers the book in a somber tone that reflects the previously stated Arctic climate of life growing up in the Bechdel home. Yet there is still complexity within the nearly monochromatic, highlighting important details within moments. In addition, Bechdel's use of ever-present narration most often sits above the panel, commenting on the past without interfering in it. As readers closely examine and re-examine moments, pieces of writing, and literary allusions, we experience Bechdel's attempt to make sense of the past right along with her. Finally, these past events and artistic choices are given an attempted cohesion through Bechdel's continual use of shifting literary allusion. These choices are not arbitrary in their selection, but are the product of the many interests and passions of her family, most notably her father. Each chapter is named after the central piece of literature used within it to translate the past. Old Father, Old Artificer, taken from Joyce's A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man, an appointed summation of Allison's father in both his love of home remodeling and his many lies. A Happy Death, from Camus' novel, which ponders the meaning of Bruce's likely suicide. That Old Catastrophe, a line in Wallace Stevens' Sunday Morning, and a summation of the many small tragedies that made up Bruce and Helen's past. In the Shadow of Young Girls in Flower, a particular title translation of In Search of Lost Time by Marcel Proust, and a reflection on Allison's coming of age and her father's reasons behind many affairs. The Canary-Colored Caravan of Death, an allusion to The Wind in the Willows, whose darker bent here reflects the constant presence of death given the family's funeral home, aka the fun home. The Ideal Husband, a play by Oscar Wilde, which, along with The Importance of Being Earnest, highlights the destructive impact of Bruce's closeted sexuality as a husband and father. And The Antihero's Journey, a summation of Bechdel's place in her family and the inverse nature of her story in relation to the many pieces of fiction she has used to understand her life. These many ideas drive at the notion that Allison and Bruce were inversions of one another. Allison, a proud lesbian with a distaste for excess. Bruce, a closeted gay man with a passion for flowery aesthetics. Their core natures put them irrevocably at odds with one another, but they still sought to find meaning in each other by trying to make the other something that they were not. It is only near the end of Bruce's life and the beginning of Allison's openness regarding being a lesbian that they find some form of acceptance and understanding of one another, even though the pain of the past cannot be forgotten. But the most telling fictional comparison is found in that of the Greek myth of Daedalus and Icarus. The inventor father and his ambitious son, who flew too high on wings of his father's design, only to burn and fall into the sea. It's a tale that is brought up early in Fun Home and is returned to time and time again, but Bechdel finds the story most true to her and her father in its inverse. And while it was Bruce who fell in the end, he was there to catch Allison when she took the chance to fly, borne up on wings that would not have been possible without her father. These small moments, these brief glimpses of peace, are possible by facing the past and all of its difficult truths. But life is far more complicated, painful, and beautiful than any single story can say. Still, using stories can help us make sense of it and accept who we are.